Hey guys, this is Abhishek from Pershini, and today we have Kanish with us, who has been selected as a graduate software engineer at Blue Optima, and we will ask him a few questions to share his experience with us.
Hello, Abhishek.
Hi Kanish. So the first question for you is, how many rounds of interviews were done, if you can recall those?
So actually we had first an initial online round.
Okay.
So there were two coding questions. So the one who cleared all of them were selected.
Okay.
And then there were personal rounds. So in that there were two rounds of normal coding questions with the interviewer. Then a project was given to complete. Then after 1 week, an HR round and a managerial round was conducted. And after that.
Okay. So in the first round of interview, you said that you had two coding questions, right?
Yes.
Okay, so do you remember the coding question or the level?
I think one was of BST.
Okay.
And second was something related to an array.
Okay, so they were like intermediate question, no dynamic programming and high level stuff,
no,
right?
No, not dynamic programming.
Okay, so after that, how many technical rounds were there?
So there were total in all three technical rounds, an HR round, and a project was given.
Okay, a project was given for you.
So, yes. Okay. When you complete the project, you have to show your code to them. They will analyze your code. They will see. So, actually, a PDF was given to us to make a feature or make a project for them.
Okay.
And when we basically present the project, they see our efforts and skills. And then they judge us on that.
Okay.
So, these were done after the rounds. So basically students were selected after each round.
Okay.
And then the final round was given. I think there were 10 to 20 students. Then there was project assigned, and then there was a final interview, then HR.
Okay. So the people were shortlisted before, then they were given a project, a week of time, right?
A week of time.
Okay. After that, they evaluated the project, took another technical round, and then there was an HR round.
Yes.
Okay. So other than the coding round and the project, what sort of questions were asked in the technical question, technical rounds?
Technical question, I remember a question was something like, you have given a two linked list, you have to add them, like there was 3, 2, 1, another linked list was 1, 2, 3, something like, do you have to add the numbers?
Okay.
That is a basic raw question in lead code. And then there was something called, so basically the round was based on my resume.
Okay.
So I had web developer resume type of thing. So they were
according to your resume, the questions were asked.
Basically the round was of an hour long, and the first 20 minutes were based on my resume, then they were coding questions.
Okay. So there was no group discussion or HR round?
No.
The last round was an HR round, right?
Yes.
So what sort of question were asked in the HR round?
Nothing too fancy, something like what your father do, something like that. Nothing.
Okay, so it wasn't an elimination round, it was
I don't think anyone was eliminated from HR.
Okay. So another thing that most of the students have heard is that projects and high GPA are very important to get placed. Is that true?
So I think not. They matter if you, I think not. They are very less. But if you have a good resume, you can definitely get an advantage. But they're not the only factor.
Okay.
And if you have a bad resume, it is not like that. You will not get a job. But if you have a good resume, it is an advantage. If you have a bad resume, you have to try a little harder. But there is nothing in college campus placement. There is very less thing given to resume. There is very less focus on that.
Okay. So what resources did you use? What books and websites did you use to prepare?
I basically use lead code.
Okay.
And I did lead code for the whole summer vacation before my placement, and then only that.
Okay. So other than that, no books for like the technical areas?
There is something, Gail Lackman book. I don't remember. Coding. I don't remember the book, but there is a book for interview questions.
Okay.
A very famous book written by Gail Lackman or something like that.
Yeah. Okay.
So I did that.
Okay. Anything different? Like, if you get a chance to go back a year, if you are in your sixth semester, anything different that you would do?
So basically, I will try to. So in our college, company comes in third year.
Okay.
And ask for internship. So all the big companies go for internship, and I think in third year there are not very much people who have that coding advantage. You have done lead code or something like that.
Yeah.
So what you can do is in the beginning of third year, in the summer vacation, you can actually go to some coding classes, or you can actually code and try a little harder for that internship.
Okay, so prepare a little earlier so that you can get an internship in third year.
Then the conversion is very high if you get an internship there.
Okay. So any suggestion you had, like, for the batches who are currently in 6M, like those who are already in 6M, it's already June. May, so they can't do a lot. So any suggestion for them to prepare for the campus placement?
Do lead code and do one more site there was. I basically did lead code.
Okay.
Do lead code every day. Try as much as that you can.
Okay.
There are around 1,000 questions. I did like 200, 300 questions only. But okay. I did it every day.
Okay. So a constant practice of coding
practice, and if you want to see the solution, you can see the solution, but you have to understand it really carefully.
Okay. So what particular language do you use to code?
I use C++.
Okay. And almost all the companies allowed you to code in C++?
Yes. Almost every campus interview allowed the questions to be in C++, but when there were personal interviews, the question was mainly about Java.
Okay, so Java has a weightage
has a weightage on interview rounds.
Okay, so other than that, do you have any internship experience when you presented your resume to all these, and were they interested in what you did?
I think they were not interested in what I did. They were interested in the projects.
Okay.
So if you don't have any internship but you have good projects, you can clear the round.
Okay, so you had web development projects, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so a lot of students are actually asking the same question, that they had a lot of web development projects. So what sort of questions did they ask you on your web development?
So basically, on my the person who was interviewing me was a developer there only on top of the company.
Yeah.
They basically asked some basic requests, the basic calls and basic functions, like what is local storage, what is an API call, what are requests, what are the differences, basic questions, and then and basically in my interview, he asked me questions about the system of my app. So I built an app, so there was a system design of my app. So basically asked me that.
So they don't actually push you, ask questions which you haven't mentioned, but only ask questions which you claim to know, right?
Yes. Okay. Basically, yes.
Yeah. Okay, that's all, Kanishk. It was a great interview.
Okay.
We'll connect to you offline as well.